So, great day today.
Sure is. Beautiful day.
It is. Yeah, so I don't know if I told you over the phone, but my name is Michael. I'm with American Income Life, and we handle all the permanent benefits for the firemen, the policemen, the teachers unions, teamsters, that type, first responders.
I heard of that. It's a very good company.
Oh, you have heard, you've heard of it. It's wonderful.
I work for an insurance company, so I know.
Oh, great. You want to tell me a little bit about that?
I work for Center Insurance. They are over in Scottsdale. I worked there for about 12 years.
Awesome.
Very nice company.
Awesome. So, you know, being that we do the permanent benefits, do you know the difference between temporary and permanent benefits?
Yes.
Oh, you do? You know, the place that you work, you basically get benefits from them. And so when you leave your work or change careers or retire, those benefits get left behind. So those would be the temporary benefits.
Okay.
So permanent benefits are the type of benefits no matter what happens, no matter where you go, they stay with you and you have them for life.
Okay.
So those are the type of benefits that we cover.
Very nice.
The permanent benefits. So I'm here for basically three reasons. Basically to cover information about the food bank program that we have, cover the no-cost union benefits that we're going to provide to you today that you got approved through one of your friends that, actually it's Raul, that's who sent me here today.
And
correct. And because Raul was in the union, the oil union, he's been there for a number of years, and the oil union has allowed him to extend some of the permanent benefits that we just talked about to you. And so because of that, we're going to cover the food bank information, the benefits that Raul was able to get you pre-qualified for, or get you able to acquire today. And then finally, if we can get you approved, some of the permanent benefits that their unions offer to some of their members. Now, it's not going to be easy to get approved. In fact, 60% of the people I present to can't even qualify. So my job is to get you qualified, go through all that information, make sure that you're familiar with all the packages and get you qualified. And at the end, I've got this little report card, and on this report card, you'll tell the unions that I was here and that I covered all the information properly. And that that I covered all the information properly, and that if you had any questions, that were covered. That's fair, right? Great. So the first thing I have for you, it's part of the talking about the food bank information. So basically, every time we come to a member's house, we're asked by our company to ask if the people would like to donate some food products. So whether canned food or dry food. So if you've ever been laid off or been in between jobs, you know how important that is to a family. So that's how we keep the food banks busy, is that type of thing. So the next thing I have is when we're all done, please feel free to tell me and I'll take that with me. Set those aside if you're interested in giving some food to the food bank. Great, the next thing to cover is our AD&D policy. Since Raul was able to get you qualified to provide you these benefits and extend them to you, that's an accidental death and dismemberment policy for $2,000. It's a real product. It's good for 1 year. And so I just need you to fill out the left-hand side and sign the bottom. So that's up to you. But I think we already have some of that started, so I'll just fill out. All I need you to do is put down who your beneficiary is. So that's fine. Sure. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, I know you're going to put Michael in there, so I'll put that in for you and we'll fill that out. Great. So this is for you to keep. So I'll keep this for my records. Once I get this entered into my system, I'm going to send you a copy of it so you have proof of it. So in case something happens, an accident or anything like that happens, then you'll have proof that you have the certificate. So I'll either email that to you or text it to you, whatever you prefer.
Thank you. That's very nice.
You're welcome. The next item I have for you is a health services card. And the health services card has a number of no-cost benefits as well as a gold program. So on this product here, it provides you eye care, hearing aid assistance, prescription drug plan, as well as chiropractic plan. And then I'll go over in a few minutes, they have a gold plan that covers dental, they, vitamin, nutritionals, travel assistance, as well as 24-hour helpline. Yeah, so over here on the bottom, there's actually information to contact them if you have any questions about the program. And then inside page here, it has more information about the program, the 800 number like we just talked about. So I'll do that for you. And then there's a code here at the bottom that if you go online, you want to use that code to get registered with the program. And so any of the partners that are involved with the program, you'll want to get that taken care of. And then as far as making sure to see if there are any places that we'll be talking to in this particular program, we want to make sure that places you're going are covered by the program that exists. So first off, we have the eye care. On the eye care product, basically you're going to get 20 to 60% off on any eye care. Yeah, which is a great benefit. Now, whatever you already have with your eye care plan, this is on top of it. Some of the other plans, it's whichever one's better, but this one is which is on top of their existing eye care coverage. So 20, 60% off on the actual new glasses, new lenses, that type of thing. And 10 to 30% off on the examinations or anything they have to do to write your script on your eye care. There's an 800 number here. You want to make sure that that particular eye care specialist is in our program. We have a lot of different ones that are already established in here. So you'll want to check that out. There's also the hearing aid plan. On the hearing aid plan, it has a discount of 10 to 20% off on all hearing aid products, and it has a list of different services and what the prices would be. So that would be something that most people don't already have as an add-on, so that would be something you could add on to your existing plan. Prescription drug plan, this is for any of the any prescriptions that you might be on. If you're taking any prescriptions, if you go to Walgreens or CVS or some of the major carriers, you can see they're here, Safeway, Walgreens, CVS, Costco, and again, double check to make sure it's Kruger. Part of Fry's program. So that's a prescription care. This is what the card looks like. That'll come in the mail about 2 weeks after you apply. And then on the inside here is the website. So if you want to apply on the website, that's the website to go to. Again, that code on that other side, is you would key that in. It'll ask for your social security number. You don't have to put that in there. And then there's also a chiropractic plan that's in here as well, and that will cover 20 to 40% off on your chiropractic. Also some discounts on your examinations as well, similar to the eye plan. And so those are the no-cost benefits. And then they offer for the first year trial basis a gold plan, which is $24.95. And those cover the things that we mentioned, which was the dental plan. That was really quick. So that covers dental, the vitamin nutritional supplements, mail order products that we have, and travel assistance, as well as 24-hour care, nursing care. That's exactly what it sounds like. So let's go back to the dental. On the dental, you're going to get 10 to 50% off on your dental care, and you're going to get orthodontics, dentures, cosmetic dentistry, crowns, extractions, fillings, oral surgery. You see it's quite a list that you'll get a discount on. So it works for the whole family, it's not just yourself. On the prescription or the supplemental side, you can get 25 to 50% off on the supplementals. So you know how it looks like you like vitamin C and B6 and some of the other supplements that you like to purchase, maybe even the fish oil, or, you know, that hair product, that would be fine. So you find those different things, go online to their site, and you'll find you're going to get 20 to 50% off. Yeah, so that'll really help. So most people save somewhere between $100 and $150 by just using this card, but it sounds like some of the things that are in here may be utilizing a little more than others. So we expect you to get a little bit more than that in savings. Travel assistance, so if you're ever traveling overseas and you have to get back or something happens, you know, heaven forbid something happens, you have to get bring you back to the States, this will help you. You call them and they'll help you get back. If you lost your ID and that type of thing as well. Also, there's a 24-hour nurse care line, which we just said a minute ago, 24/7, basically call the nurse, maybe save your trip to urgent care or something like that in the future.
Yeah.
Great, so this is another benefit that unions have for all their members, and this is basically given to you from Raoul, so you want to thank Raoul for all these no-cost benefits that you're already looking at right now. So, lastly, do you have a will?
Yes.
Awesome, great. That's not everybody I talked to has that, so it's great that you have that going. So this is actually a family information guide, and this family information guide is set up so that in case of emergency and heaven forbid something happens to you or your husband, that you have a plan in place that somebody can come and follow it. So all your important information goes on top here. I understand your husband was in the military, so his information will go up here on the military so that you contact them. And your, depending on who's writing this one out, this would be his information or your information, spousal and historical data. So social security numbers and those things are important to fill in. and then most important in this whole list is that you have five different people that will be in the area, in the local area, that can help. So you want your first point of contact. Hopefully that would be your son. And then second would probably be your daughter that live in the area. And then both of you should have at least three or four others, so that combined you have at least five contacts. So they give you, the reason for that is that if something were to happen, and recently I think something happened to your husband, you had to go to the urgent care, if those people are at work and they're not available, you want somebody else in the local area that can take care of you. So you want to put your son, your daughter, any of your neighbors, that type of information there. So when you said you already had a will already, right? Right. So you want to put your attorney's name here, and you want to put who your executor is, who's that point of contact that's going to handle the will once something were to happen to either of you, or both of you. So if you had any insurance at work through Century, I think you said you worked at Century Insurance?
Yeah, I have.
So if you have any insurance that you got through work, you want to put that in pencil, because if you leave or retire or change jobs, you want to make sure that you know that the people that are looking into this know that it's temporary because you're no longer there. Anything else you want to put in pen. The next section is the financial institution information. So your checking account, savings account, do you use a checking and savings account? Great. So we want to put all that information in there as much as possible so that they know where the money is for the person that's going to caretake for you. And then also they can use the accounts for any type of emergencies that may have caused because of the situation that just occurred. Do you know if you have a safety deposit box?
Yeah.
Great. So whatever bank it's at and wherever it's located, that's where that would go. That's fine. That's what that space is for. Funeral service request. This is very important because when this happens, I spoke to you last time. Yeah, you told me that you had that set up. So there's certain things that might be in there that aren't covered. But first off, you want to make sure in this section that person that gets this would understand your requesting to be buried. I think you told me so. Earth burial versus cremation. So you want to make sure that they identify that, and then any places that you're set up through and where those are. If you go to the bank and have it notarized and wait to sign it to when you're with them, because when the notaries, they want to see your signature, then this actually works as a legal document to help you with some of that final arrangements that you might have.
Very nice.
Great. So this is the family insurance, our family information guide. It's for you to keep, and you'll want to put it in a safe place, but not a safe, because if it's in a safe, you won't be able to get access to it. And we'll give you a spare one to give to the person that's going to be the person in charge. So you'll want to update that if anything changes in between time. Great. So, like I said before, the other reasons why I'm here is to talk about some of the permanent benefits that Raul was able to extend your way. It's gonna be very difficult to get qualified for them, but I'm gonna have a few questions I have to ask you and see if I can go a little bit further.
Is that part real?
It's all real.
About?
Sure.
Do you know
Raul? Raul, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's in the oil union and he's extended his benefits to you. That is
for real. Really?
Yeah.
That's for real?
Yeah. Yeah, that's for real.
That's pretty nice.
Yeah, so basically I have a few questions to ask. If you've ever had a DWI?
Never.
Ever been arrested?
Never.
Are you a smoker?
Never.
Marijuana?
Never.
You promise?
Absolutely.
Okay. And then next, if you have a family history, or any history of yourself having any injuries or diagnosed with any illness over your lifetime? No? Great. And then as far as your family history, I think we talked about it before. There was a, I think on my father's side, there was a heart attack situation on some of his family members, so heart disease. And I think on your side, some pre-existing some old cancers that were there. Yeah, so, with that information, I think you'd still qualify. So I think I would be able to continue further and be able to show you more about the permanent benefits. So we'll kind of keep going through that. So ever seen this before? It's a blue binder, and that's the permanent benefits that you get from the unions. So as a union member, and once they qualify for it, like Raul did, then he has full access to the permanent benefits that are in here. So these are actually the permanent benefits. They're actually put together by this council, and these are all the different unions that are out there and all the presidents.
See if I can recognize them.
Yeah, so there's different unions in there, and if you don't mind, I'll show you some on the back. And so these are actually the members that help us design some of these benefits that help us fill in those gaps that we were talking about between what you get at work and what you get from the permanent benefit side. So, you know, there's teachers unions, there's the Fraternal Order of Police in here, there's the NFL union right here, there's quite a bit of unions in here. So the company that American Income Life has a very high rating, and because of the high rating, they're able to pay for their policyholders very quickly. So they have a very high standard, and if you're a union member, you know they want the best, so you know that working with us, we're the best and hammering the permanent benefits. And again, so, you know, you can kind of flip through that. And then, so what we want to do is cover a little bit of it's covered in this permanent benefits. You're going to have an accident injury information policy. You're going to have a final funeral and settlement type program, and then finally a paycheck protection. So those are the types of programs that the unions have put aside for you. And the union has a motto. Basically, you take care of these benefits now while you're young, while you aren't ill, and while you can afford it. So have you ever heard of the power hour philosophy? Mm-hmm. Basically, you work a 40-hour week, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so what the union does is they take 1 hour of a 40-hour week, and they apply it toward their benefits for their family and their future. So the reason why they do 1 hour is so that with 1 hour, generally it's small enough that that would be something they would barely notice, because most of the time people making the 40 hour a week, their surplus money goes to things they just excess. So Starbucks, they kind of waste some of that money and they don't really plan for the future. And because I see so many members, I notice that most of them have nowhere near enough money saved aside or planned for their future. And so the unions have made that a policy, so that the power hour is taking that 1 hour every week. Yeah, so taking that 1 hour every week so that they have protection for their family. And you know that working 1 hour and taking away 1 hour from your weekly paycheck, you probably wouldn't even notice it. You know, basically if you work a 40-hour week, next week you work a 39-hour week, you probably didn't know, you even barely notice it in your pay. That's the reason why that happens, is because that's a small enough amount that they can set aside that most people wouldn't even notice.
Okay.
So what my job is, I'll go through a little bit further actually. The unions usually make between $20 and $60 an hour. And I'm sorry, $20 and $100 an hour. And depending on where they are, electrical union workers and some of the higher end plumbers, master plumbers and that type of thing, make it $100 range an hour. And so most families set aside between $40 and $60 a week for these types of benefits. So my job is to basically take that $40 and tell you what you're gonna receive for that. So I was looking at your guys' pay stubs and we talked a little bit about it. You know, I noticed that your husband makes $25 an hour and you make $15 an hour. So combined, it's about 40 hours. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you what $40 an hour is gonna do for you in your benefits. So I took a little bit of liberty and set it up a little bit before we started. And so the first part is about the accidents. So your hospital benefits, accident benefit. So if you have to go to an emergency room and have anything checked out, whether it's a scraped knee, a stitches, or anything that you feel that needs to be addressed right away, we're gonna send you $150 for that visit. The next thing, the only exception to that is if you end up spending the night in the hospital, we're gonna send you $300 a day for up to 365 days or a year. So that adds up to about $2,100 a week. And don't you think that $2,100 a week would make a big difference?
If
you know, your bills are still need to be paid, those things still need to be happened. So the next is if you have, the exception to that is if you're having to go into intensive care, they're gonna give you $600 per day. Up to 2 weeks or $4,200 for that 14 days if that was the case, and that's because it's such a probably unexpected but such a dramatic thing that you'll want to have that a little extra much. You can understand that, right? So this will cover you any of your benefits while you're. You know, your work probably covers all of the medical part, as well as workman's comp will cover any of the things that you may have at work, and your medical will cover anything that you may have gotten for an accident. But this is meant to cover you while you're there, because when you're not, when those things happen, you're not at work, you still got to pay the bills, you still got to keep the lights on, you still got to kind of go that route. So the next item that we'll be talking about is it's called a freedom of choice, and show you the certificate. So this certificate is called a Freedom of Choice Certificate, and basically first responders, firemen, anybody in a hazardous type of job, the last thing that the unions want to have with the spouses to worry about is what happens if something, you know, heaven forbid something were to happen and they were to pass away, especially on the job. So the last thing that they want the spouse to worry about is what happens when you go to a funeral home. So I don't know if you have you ever had to plan a funeral before. If you had, you know that when you go to the funeral director and he comes to you and says, you know, I'm so sorry for your loss, but your husband passed away. His funeral is going to cost $15,000. He's going to ask you where that money is going to come from, and so you're going to most likely you'll be either digging into savings. In your case, it's covered for some parts of it. But there might be still some other items, the actual ceremony and flowers and sending lots of those other type of incidentals would happen. They're gonna wanna know that you have a money set aside for that. So they're gonna ask you where that money's gonna come from. So so what they've done is come up with this Freedom of Choice product, and basically allows you to prepay all the costs for that in this policy. So basically we've set it up so that your husband will have $30,000 benefit. He'll have $30,000, and each of your children will have $10,000 each. And so what happens is you tell them that my husband has the Freedom of Choice program, and you give him the certificate. You want to make sure before you give him the certificate so that they negotiate that price, whatever it is for the funeral is done, because because once you give that to them and it's $15,000, for instance, the remainder will go to your beneficiaries. So you say, that's already been taken care of. My husband had the Freedom of Choice program, and this gives them information that's actually signed by us so that they understand it. And they've seen these before, so they understand the product. And the reason why it's called Freedom of Choice is because you can go anywhere in the U.S., continental U.S., as well as Hawaii and Canada. And so if you need...
So that means you can get married?
To any of the places that you request. In your case, you've already pre-selected the place, but some of the incidentals that may not be covered, which is some of the arrangements you just talked about, which was the part, flowers and the church and the notifications to everybody and what's happening and that type of thing. So you just basically give them a certificate and that's covered. So lastly, we're going to cover the, hi there. Just covering some of the stuff that we went over the other day, so I'm just rehashing it again with my mom, Rosa. And so the last thing is paycheck protection. So, you know if something, heaven forbid, something were to happen to your husband and he were to pass away, the bills still come in, you still got to pay your mortgage, you still got to pay for all the different things that come up in your normal bills. But if something were to happen to him, his income's gone. So one of the things they thought about was to help fill in that gap is that, you know, all the other things, you've got, probably got life insurance. Most people carry between $700,000 and $900,000 in life insurance, and that's generally through the company. You know, this will help you with immediate money within 72 hours, and you'll be receiving a monthly check coming directly to your house, and that would be for his full pay of $6,287.42 will come in every month for 1 year. And the reason for the year is because a couple months generally isn't enough time to adapt to that, having your significant other person there in your life. So we extend that to a year. And if you qualify, then we actually have it extended in this particular example up to 3 years. So that depends on your income and what we've done, but that's part of what we put together. And then because if something were to happen to you, your husband would get $2,600 a month that offsets the your income that you have. So that's there for you. So some of the other things that happen if you, after 3 years, and you've been paying on the policy, then that becomes cash value. And that cash value can actually be applied in case you lose your job or change your jobs. They can take that money and pay your premiums, so you'll never lose it, so you keep your permanent benefits in place for yourself. Then over a period of time, you can, after you retire and you get to the age of retirement, you can retire and have your PVEP insurance taken care of, so that after you retire you don't have to make the premiums anymore. You can build this into the policy now, so that when you do retire, that you have a paid up part of your policy. Lastly, terminal illness rider. Basically, if something were to happen to you and you were having to pass away, you get 50% of what we've set aside for you from your freedom of choice, as well as those accidents cares that we were talking about. You can utilize 50% of that now. You do the bucket list type of things, or the remainder will go to your beneficiaries that's on your list. And I did neglect to kind of go through one last piece, and I apologize, but if you're in a car accident, if you're ever in an accident and you were to pass away, you're going to get $80,000 for yourself, and then your husband will also have $80,000. And then if, heaven forbid, you get into a car accident, which is probably the most common accident, they'll give you $110,000. And then if you're on a common carrier, like a plane, a train, or a bus, then they'll give you $200,000. So these are also set up for you as additional benefits. So we covered the paycheck protection. So basically now what I'll do is summarize all the things. So kind of looking at the different packages that are set up for the unions. You know, the union's motto, I think I mentioned it earlier, is far as the, you know, the hospital benefits, that's to cover you when you're in the hospital for any things that you have to, your food and your expenses and things that happen while you're there. Freedom of choice is to cover you with your final funeral costs and your final settlements. Accident protection, if something were to happen to you and you wanted to have accident coverage, that would be $80,000, $110,000, and $200,000, whether that's a car accident or car repair. And you have your final, your monthly paycheck protection. And then all the other things on the right to kind of help us if you decide to get some of that coverage. So all that is going to be your, it's going to be, yeah, that's going to be your
freedom of choice.
Permanent benefits that you get that we're setting up for you for that $40. So now that we've kind of covered that, you know, the most important thing, if something were to happen to both you and your husband at the same time, who would you want to have, and there'll be money left over, who would you like to have all that go to? Your first beneficiary, right?
Children.
Sure. Yeah, so that's great. And so looking at these products that we just went over, this was set up for 1 hour of your weekly pay. And so looking at the 1 hour, some people come to us and say, you know, what if I pay double that, can I get double the benefits? And so that would definitely be an option. We could double some of those costs and go to higher amounts on different levels depending on what your expectations are to fill in some of the gaps that you already have. Maybe you don't have life insurance, or maybe you want to supplement this a little bit more. And some people want us to just do the program I just told you, which was the 1 hour at $40 a week. And that's enough to get started, and you know that's the way it's designed, so that'll protect you. If you were to choose which one of those you'd want to do, would you want to do the 1 hour or 2 hours?
I probably like the 2 hours.
The 2 hours, great. So you want to get
double the money, right?
Double the benefits. Awesome. Well, what I'm going to do now then is, now that you've kind of decided that looks like a good option for you, I need to get you pre-qualified. Again, it's not going to be easy. Not everybody qualifies. I've got quite a list of questions I need to ask you to go through that. Take about 20 to 30 minutes.
Okay.
So we'll do that really quickly and then see if you qualify.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
That was it, huh?